We have a great treat. Larry, Steve, and Rudy, the Gatlin brothers, they've been performing together for almost as long as they've been alive, like 65 years. Now, some of them might tell you for as long as they've been alive. Their career has been filled with well-deserved highs, including several number one hits, a Grammy Award, and numerous ACM nominations. But there have also been a few unexpected lows. And as you can see by the shirt that Larry is wearing tonight, they have never taken the lows lying down. So to talk about all of their incredible career as well as their run-ins with cancel culture, I want you to welcome some of our very favorites, the Gatlin brothers.
Hey,
Thank you. We're excited to have you guys here.
Thank you.
And Larry, you and I have particularly talked about the whole world of cancel culture, how if you disagree with somebody who's in power, they don't want to just disagree with you. They want to put you out of business, shut you up, and get rid of you, never to be heard from again. People won't let songs be heard. We have trouble, even on this show, getting clearances for songs. And the publishers will say, no, we don't want it to be on the Huckabee Show.
Absolutely. Well, this is kind of in jest. I believe we all matter, and I'm going to address that a little bit later in a song. In the 18th century, the Scottish philosopher, Lord Andrew Fletcher of Saltoun, he said, Saltoun, Scotland, S-A-L-T-O-U-N. That's Saltoun. It's not T-O-O-N. Anyway, T-U-N-E. He said, very mystically, he said, were I able to write the ballads of a nation, were I able to write the songs of a nation, I would care not who wrote its laws. Folks, if we don't think that Bob Dylan and Joan Baez and Joni Mitchell and Stephen Stills, if we don't think that those songwriters and entertainers were instrumental in ending the Vietnam War, you're crazy. Of course they did.
Yeah.
They got young people out in the streets protesting with the music and all of that. George Frederick Root, 200 years ago, and the lady, woman, girl, female, dear God, we don't know what to call them, start out with sweetheart. They wrote a little song that's kind of important. You ready?
Red and yellow, black and white, they are precious in His sight. Jesus loves the little children of the world.
So do Larry, Steve, and Rudy.
Yeah.
We really do. So songs matter. I had... it's okay if I take the credit as long as I give God the glory. Because the book says, God forbid that I glory save in the cross of Jesus Christ. So I will not take the glory, I'll take the credit. Yeah, I write the songs and I'm grateful for all that. None of that would have happened without these two. They sing, I tell people, when I get the words right, the melodies are the easy part. If you get the words right, and by the way, all of the words you need for those songs are in the dictionary. You just got to figure it out.
Just arrange it in the right way.
But I hear the harmonies. I hear His low part in my right ear and His high part in my left ear. If it weren't for these two, my brothers who I love and adore and would fight for, none of this would have happened. So give my sidekicks another hand. They are they're what we're about.
I'm glad that all of you have been singing and continue to entertain people. And I just want to just wrap it up by reminding folks that if we can't use your songs on TV, then you don't get paid, because you get paid when we use those songs. And one of the things that has scratched our heads is it's really theft from the songwriters and the artists to not be able to use the music that you've written and that's sitting on the shelf for a catalog to be bought. But Maybe you can work on it.
The people who are doing that, the cancel people, first of all, I don't know if you can say this, I think they're a bunch of booger-eating morons.
They're
well... You just said it.
You just said it, so...
First of all, what you're doing, Gov...
How you like us so far.
Yeah.
Good night.
You're confusing all this with logic. Dr. Alan Bloom said in his book, The Closing of the American Mind, he said, there's one thing a college professor can be assured of when he or she walks into a classroom and asks the question, is there any such thing as right or wrong? 90% of them will say, no, it's relative. It's relative. Well, guess what, friends and neighbors? Red lights aren't relative. You go up to a red light and just say, that isn't red, that's green. go ahead and go through that and see how that works out for you.
Not very well.
So they don't care about what's right or wrong. They have the power right now. But I think they're going to get...
There's a reckoning.
There was a reckoning.
I hope so. Well, I want our audience to know how to experience the Gatlin's 65 years of music for themselves. So they're going to get ready to perform tonight, which we wouldn't bring them here and not let them perform. Keith is going to tell us how we can get their wonderful music that nobody can keep us from being able to get to.
I'd be happy to. Just go to GatlinBrothers.com to find their music, tour schedule, and a whole lot more.